Do you hear me?
Yes, Marty, I can hear you.
Isn't this cool? Sound is just vibrations through a medium like the air, or in this case, this string. It's vibrating and your ear interprets that, and that's how you hear me. Cool!
Okay, so what does this have to do with the International Space Station?
How do you think we communicate with the astronauts in low Earth orbit? The space station's in a vacuum. There's no air molecules to vibrate.
It's a little more complicated than two cans and a piece of string. For that, we use the space network, made up of special satellites, like the tracking and data relay satellite model behind us.
I kind of wondered why we were standing here.
First, for the sound to reach us, it has to be converted into microwaves. Those microwaves are sent through space to the tracking and data relay satellites that are in orbit around Earth, and then to the ground stations to be received.
That is a little bit more complex than my can and string.
Even though the ISS is going 17,500 miles per hour, about 250 miles away from Earth, through this space network, we can still communicate and send other information to those on board, no matter where they are in orbit.
One of the cool things that we've gotten a chance to do is connect with the International Space Station for a downlink, allowing students to talk to astronauts while they're in orbit. Check it out.
STEM in 30, this is Mission Control Houston. Please call station for a voice check.
Station, this is STEM in 30. How do you hear me?
And I have you loud and clear at the Air and Space Museum. Very good to be with you today.
Hi, Serena. This is Beth Wilson and Marty Kelsey, and we are really excited to be talking to you right now. We have a bunch of kids with a lot of questions, and to begin, Marty's got a question.
Serena, how has your first trip into space been so far?
You know, it has been outstanding. The rocket ride up here was absolutely amazing, and it's really fascinating to see how quickly your body gets used to moving in space and realizing you have so much more space to float in and fly in here than you do just by walking on the ground.
Hi, I'm Seth. What is your favorite experiment that you have done in the ISS, and how will it benefit us on Earth?
So one of the experiments I did the very first week with my crewmate Alex Gerst from Germany was something called myotones. And what that experiment did is it looked at Alex's muscles, and we basically are studying those muscles to see how he changes while he's up here during 6 months. And you may think, well, why is that important to me? Well, if you've ever been in the hospital for a long time, or maybe your grandma or grandpa, you know that when they come out of the hospital, sometimes they're really weak because they've been lying in a bed. And so we're trying to figure out how our muscles change, because we think it's the same as it would be in grandma or grandpa in the hospital. Because for most of the day, we're floating around. You know, we're not using our leg muscles. And could we somehow keep them from not getting weak in the hospital? Could we develop new methods to keep them strong?
Hello, Serena. How do you do repairs on the space station?
So we'll often do repairs inside the space station. Like, for example, if the toilet breaks or anything like that, then we'll do repairs on that inside. But if a bigger piece of equipment breaks, then often we have to fix it on the outside of the space station. And if we do that, then we have to do a spacewalk. And we put on our two big spacesuits and head out the door. And we're talking with Mission Control in Houston the whole time to make sure that everything we're doing is correct. And it's a really important day when that happens on board the space station, because everybody's involved and we want to make sure we keep everybody safe.
We have a challenge for you. We want you to create your own can string telephone. What design are you going to use? Does it work? Share those with us down in the comments section. And if you like this video, be sure to follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.